Hello guys, how are you doing? So I hope you had a beautiful Sunday. For us, it was amazing. We went out the whole day. We were in the park in Valencia. We have a big park which is all around the city. It's like almost 10 kilometers long, and you can like do sports. So we had like the slack line. We had our ball to play the ball with our daughter and also with our friends. We had picnic there, just amazing, amazing day. We just came back a few hours ago, and my daughter is went fall asleep just when we were coming back. So she will probably wake up very soon. So I will not do the live very long because I don't want her to just become crazy and not see me when she's waking up. I'm still breastfeeding, so she needs me when it's the evening. So yeah, today we are going to talk about the content. As you know, we talked about it a bit yesterday. So in fact, some of the things that I had planned to talk about today, I talked about it yesterday, and I also mentioned the green, like the how to have a beautiful feed. And some of you asked me for the guide for this. I send it over to you. If you want this guide for free, just let me know and I will be happy to send it over to you as well. But let's see other things today. So what are the content that you can use? First, one thing you have to think, what are the people loving about my place? Huh? So all the things, and also who are my ideal guests, who they are, what do they like? So for instance, I know Michelle, you have a lot of people who are coming for bicycle trails. Some people are coming for the museum. Some people are coming because they love your garden. So those are the pictures that you want to show on your Instagram because that's what the people, your like main guests love to see about your place and love to know about your place. So you can show different places around your place that people love to do. Then there are pictures that people are engaging more on Instagram than others. So that's something I want to talk about today with you so that you know, okay, which picture can I post? Again, in the guide that I can send you, there is a kind of like something to follow so that you have a nice design. And you can see, okay, this picture can go here, this picture can go here. And this is taking into account what I will say now. So one of the pictures that people love very much is something which is inspirational. So because people who are coming to your place probably either they are coming for a business trip or they are coming for holidays. Most of you probably they are coming for holidays. If they are coming for holidays, they probably will love quotes about traveling. So try to find as many quotes about traveling as possible and post them on your feed and ask a question with it. We will go afterwards today on what to write in the caption for each post. But first, yeah, put pictures which are like beautiful quotes that you can find online for travelings. Travelings for freedom, for lifestyle, if you have like a very target audience, for instance, like people who like tennis for Charmian, then you can put inspirational quotes from tennis players, anything that is related to your audience, to the people who are coming to your place, be sure to use this as a quote. So that's one of the pictures that people love very much. The second thing that people like very much, it's a bit strange, but in fact, some of the best Instagram accounts, some are who are making like have the most followers and things like this, are pictures of chats. So they are showing you the chat box, like the conversation with other people. Why? Because probably because people are curious. And they like to see those things also. Usually they share something which is humorous. How to apply this to your own business? How to make it a good strategy for your vacation rental? Well, you might have exchange text after your stay and people their stay with previous guests. They might have sent you a text saying how like happy they were about your place, so they did this, they loved this, and you probably reply to them, thanking them for their stay and offering them to come for another time. Then this is a kind of image, you can take a screenshot, and this is a kind of image that you could share very easily on your Instagram accounts, and that could also help. And you can ask a question as well. We will go in the caption afterwards, but that's another picture that you can share. Then a picture which is working, kind of picture which is working very, very good, is pictures of holidays. So you have a lot, depending on where you are, you have different holidays, but, and especially nowadays, you know, like we created a lot of new holidays. Last week, I don't remember which day, but it was National Day of Daughters. So you can, you know, put a picture about this and ask people to comment about this. Again, like we will talk about how to get people engaged and ask the right questions. So this is one type of things. I'm talking about Daughter's Day because it was not too long ago. But of course, you have like those more most traditional ones. You will have Thanksgiving very soon. So you know something which is very, very, very trendy. It was very trendy last year as well for Thanksgiving and for this period of, you have all the pumpkins fields. You can share pictures of this. You can share a picture with a story behind it about your place. So Thanksgiving, Easter, Christmas, Valentine's Day, put pictures which are related to the holidays, and you can, in the caption, again, I'm talking about something that I will just talk after, but in the caption, you can ask people, okay, what are you going to do for Thanksgiving? What's your favorite meal for Thanksgiving? What's the best gift you had for Christmas? Anything related to this holiday, and which is asking people to comment and engage on the post. So that's another picture. And then let me remember, okay, there was this, we said this as well. We shared, yes, that's, I share, I'm looking at my notes. Yeah, yes, and the best one of the best one as well. It's very good if people, if you already, it's when you already have kind of a following, this one, huh? But when you already have kind of a following, or you have people who have been to your place, you know they are following you on Instagram, one good thing is also related to what we talked about last week, the giveaways and the contest. You can ask people, so following you, to post a picture and tag you of their stay at your place. That way, it will attract more attention, more visibility to your place. And those are pictures which are very good to see on your feed, that because you can reshare it once they share it on their account, tagging you, you will get visibility on their account. And you reshare it and you say that you will feature their picture on your account afterwards, and they can win, for instance, a free free stay or a free breakfast or whatever you want to give in addition to the best picture. So you can do a contest like this. You can announce, okay, to be featured on the account and have the possibility to win whatever you want to offer. Post the best picture you took at our place. This is really helping you to be visible on their account and also to have content for your account. So those were the five types of pictures that you can have on your feed. Again, on the design, be sure to ask me for how to have the design to know how to do it. One other thing that people love, and we talked about the chats, also some people, you can share the reviews and say how happy you are. You can also share it, this is something we'll talk afterwards as well, in the stories. You can share the reviews. And one thing I wanted to say, usually it's, this is very trendy as well right now. It's people, it's pictures of inside the homes. And it's trendy not even for only vacation rentals, it's trendy for everyone. Apparently we like to have an inside sneak of inside other people's house. And as you are vacation rental, it's very important to show people what's inside. So feel free to share any picture of inside your house. In fact, for Michelle in her account, this is one of the pictures that are working the best because people love to see. And you can also ask questions. Like for instance, you put different pillows, or you say, what would be the best colors for our next pillows here? Do you prefer blue or yellow? We are thinking of putting some new flowers. What do you think? This flower or this plant? Ask people for commenting, and they love to engage on this. So those were the picks. Another pick that people like as well is pick about what you're doing, what you like to do in the area, and also about your family. You can post a pic, not every day, but put pics about what you're doing and sharing why you love hosting. So that's another thing that is really good to do. So those were the different types of pictures that you can put. Try to create it with a design so it's kind of like nice looking when people look and they want to follow you to see what you're posting. So that was one thing. Second thing I wanted to talk about today is the caption. So the caption, what it is, it's what you will put. You will put the picture and then you will put the caption. It's like the description of the picture. What I really recommend and what I've been saying already, mentioning all the different types of pictures, always ask a question. Always ask a question in this caption, in this description, so that people are engaging. And what I would really recommend in the questions, you ask a question like, for instance, we said for holidays, what is your favorite things to do when it's Thanksgiving? And also add to tag people. So this is something to get more visibility, get more followers. As you said, that's what we all want using Instagram, more followers and thus more possible bookings. So say, ask, always ask for something. Ask people to tag. Say, tag one person you love to spend this holiday with, or tag one person you love to go biking with, tag one person you like to do tennis with. Depending on what your place is offering and what your pictures is showing, ask people to tag one person. That way they will tag and the person will also see your account. Another thing, so we said like ask question, ask for people to tag. Another thing, share a story in the description, not just like put bluntly the pictures without explaining anything more. Put a story behind the picture, sharing like what your guests love doing, if you are showing like some points of interest about the city, or why you love this place, why how you thought about the details when putting the decoration in this room. Anything, share a story, not something like how can I say? Yeah, something with feelings, you know? Some like people love to read stories, so don't just put a description, okay, picture of the patio or picture of the outdoor area. No, say, and you have space, so share the story behind the picture. You can go into details. People really like those kind of caption. So that's one thing. Have a story in the caption. Ask a question and ask people to tag someone else. So that's one thing. Then, in the caption, one mistake that people are doing is to put hashtags. Don't put hashtags in the caption. Put hashtags, and that's the third thing we'll talk about today. Put the hashtags in the first comment. Yesterday we talked a bit about the hashtag. We said to list, okay, the best hashtags between 1,000, 10,000 posts for those hashtags. And one of the homework what I told you to do yesterday is to look for those hashtags. Have them in the first comment. Have between 10, 20 hashtags in the comments. Have specific hashtags which are targeting your audience, what they like to do, the area where you are. If you are near the beach, you put like holidays by the beach. Anything related to your place, you put it in the hashtag. If you're putting a picture of tennis, find hashtags about tennis. If you're putting pictures about flowers or decorations, be specific and not just put flowers. As I said, it's a hashtag which is too wide. Put something which is quite specific, and this will help you. And put it in the comments, not in the caption. So that's one thing. Next thing I wanted to talk about, we said like the caption, we talked about the image, which image to choose, the hashtags we just said, how to use stories. Okay, so how to use stories. This is something I already talked about yesterday. We talked about the highlights. How to do the highlights is with stories. Use the stories for everything. The most you use the stories, the best. As I said, people are not looking that much in the feed. They are looking much more at the stories of people because we don't have so much time. So share anything in the stories. Share what people love doing around your place. You can take a small video of an area around your place. You can take a small video shot about your vacation rental. You can have a picture or a screenshot of a review. You can have a picture or screenshot of this chat messages with a previous guest. Something like this, or also not only previous guests. I'm thinking about it because one person is coming over and over and over to our place. So return guests, like she's just asking if we have availability for next week. So something like this, and saying, oh, how much you love to have return guests, how much you love to build a relationship with your guests. This can be shared in the stories. What I told you as well yesterday is to do live. Again, you can do live sharing about your thinking. It doesn't have to be related to your vacation rental. It can be related to your life in general. Something that is inspiring you, something that you have in your mind and you would like to share with people. For instance, last week I shared about dreams on my profile and how I feel like that everyone should have his own dreams and not dreams that the society is telling you to do, and really walk in direction to those dreams, not the dreams of the society, and do one step every day and very often to reach those dreams. Share anything you have in your mind that you would like to share with people. Of course, you don't have to just share something like not that important. Share your thoughts. People will probably relate to it and will feel a connection. That's what we want. We want to have the connection with your followers in the stories. So those are the things, and as I said yesterday, if you haven't watched the video, watch the video from yesterday, but have like highlights with stories that you create with stories of different places of your place, reviews, thing about you. So if you do a live, you can do about you. If you do some videos live, inspirational, say have a highlight inspirational, have if you are traveling, probably you're traveling, if you're doing Airbnb, if you like traveling, then you can have highlights and stories sharing your travels, anything you like. And in the stories, as I said yesterday, in the stories, you can have one hashtag. This is the best way to try out different hashtags. Huh? So have a hashtag, as I said yesterday. I don't want to repeat myself, but I want to be sure that you know this. Try one hashtag, see the insight if it's good or not. So that's mainly it for today, I think. Let me just say the attractive layout, I discussed about it and I already told you yesterday. So yes, So those are the questions that I want you to ask yourself. What are the things people prefer about your place? Be sure to put pictures of those things in your Instagram feed. What are the things people like to do when coming to your place? That's also things, pictures that you want to have in your feed. What are the best 20 hashtags? And that's something I want you to do today. Feel free also to share it here in the group so that we can see, okay, those hashtags are good, too big, too wide, or too small. I will be happy to help you on this one. And which story can I tell around each picture? Yes, again, for each picture that you will post, think about me. I know it might be difficult at the beginning, but really share a story. Don't only put like details without feelings behind. Have a story in the caption. So that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed the live, and probably most of you will watch it in replay. If you watch it in replay, put hashtag replay and put any questions that you have in the comments. That way I can reply you today or tomorrow when I wake up. If you have any question, you can also send me a direct message. And if you want a free strategy call, feel free to ask for it. I have a few spots left for next week. That was it. Enjoy your Sunday. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow. Same time, same place.